putting someone on the moon, Behavior Analyst was involved. Sesame Street, Behavior Analyst was there too. Apple's user experience lab during the heyday, you probably guessed it, Behavior Analyst was there as well. As the mother of all sciences, our field is in a position to impact the world in just about every way imaginable. We're primarily known for autism treatment or serving people with intellectual and neurological disabilities. If you look at the BACB's website, we are 67% autism, 12% education, 8% developmental disabilities, and then there are over a dozen other areas of practice that are between 0.03% and 2.12%. And we do some amazing work there and still have a lot of refinement to do to better deliver and help people in those positions. But what I've found is that there are applications that people either don't know or for whatever reason aren't spoken about as much by our community. So today I wanted to share two of my favorites with you. What our field has discovered is that the fine understanding of stimulus control, that is how things come to grab our attention and influence us to do things, can lead to learning how to leverage that to develop solutions to some serious issues that humans experience. In the late 1990s, a team challenged themselves to try to develop a program that could teach children to read without ever hearing or seeing them. Like, think about that for a second. You want to teach someone how to read and understand it without ever hearing or seeing that person. This was a time when they had dial-up internet and a mouse. That was it. And thanks to an interdisciplinary team, they developed the educational technology that did just that. And at over a 90% success rate. Why does this matter? That team of 30 or so people taught 3 million children to read without ever hearing or seeing them. And the children enjoyed it. Let's shift gears a little bit. You're in Mozambique. You just fought for your independence from Portugal, and a civil war breaks out in 1976. 15 years, war-torn country, and landmines are scattered everywhere. Apartment complexes, schools, literally placed in schools. So in 1992, they start a demining program. It takes 2 days to clear something that's about the size of a tennis court with the current technology. You know, humans walking around with those little things. Again, a team of interdisciplinary professionals, including a behavior analyst with impeccable skill sets in understanding and shaping stimulus control, develops a solution. Using African pouched rats to sniff out the landmines, locating them faster. Remember, a person can cover a tennis court in about 2 days. They can cover this in just 20 minutes. And they can locate them more safely as they're not heavy enough to disrupt and actually trigger the explosives. Now, a country can not only rest from the threat and horror, but children can go back to school. Mothers and fathers don't have to stress as much, and the local economy can begin to turn around. So while behavior analysts thrive in predominantly one area of application, our history shows us that there are no limits to our science. The field is rich with history dating back to the early 20th century, but given the progression of technology coupled with the demand of therapists, these amazing solutions are stuck often in small esoteric books or in the behavioral histories of behavior analysts who have yet captured them for the world to share. This is the basis for a presentation that I'm developing for Tate Behavioral's first annual conference in Springfield, Massachusetts. If you're near there, I'd love to see you there. As an attendee, I will make sure that you walk away with a respect for the breadth of our field and understanding of what it takes to develop a behavioral technology and the factors that impact stimulus control, affecting human behavior in scalable ways that can truly save the world. Putting someone on the moon, behavior analyst was involved. Sesame Street, behavior analyst was there too. Apple's user experience lab during the heyday, you probably guessed it, behavior analyst was there as well. That's your daily BA.